I, Christian Croucher.
I, Christian Croucher.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
Take you, Tiffany.
Take you, Tiffany.
Hi, Tiffany Hollow.
Hi, Tiffany Hollow.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
Take you, Christian.
Take you, Christian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
First time we ever hung out, he took me to school.
She told me to pick her up from school one day. And she didn't plan on her parents being there.
And my parents didn't know that he was taking me to school. He shows up, and they're like, who is that? Because they were both supposed to be at work. And both of them ended up still being there. So
went up there to pick her up, and had to meet the parents before. Wasn't really expecting that.
You were kind of mad. I didn't tell him I was riding to school with some stranger. But the whole way to school, we didn't say a word to each other. We were both really shy.
And then the whole ride to school, she sat over there and didn't say one word to me. First kiss was probably in this cool parking lot.
Before we walked into school, he just grabbed me and kissed me.
It was good.
We walked into school all blushing and everything.
It was short but sweet.
He was home over Christmas, and when we were at my house one night, and he tried tying the ring to the cat.
I attempted to tie it to her cat.
The cat didn't really care for that,
but the cat was putting up a fight.
So he kind of flipped out and scratched Chris, and then
it scratched me.
He put him in a box, and when I came out of the bathroom, the cat jumped out of the box and he got down on one knee and asked. It was fun.
Tried to make it special, but the cat didn't really like that.
Kind of romantic. I'm glad he incorporated the cat. The cat's mean.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Dear friends in Christ, we are gathered here today in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Christian and Tiffany in holy marriage. This is a good and honorable thing, which God himself has established and blessed, and by which he gives us a picture of the very communion of Christ and his bride, the Church. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for your mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in good times and in bad, and as it is God's will, for the raising of children in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is to be entered into faithfully in accordance with the purposes for which it was established by God. Let us pray. And the reading which Christian and Tiffany selected to be read today is from the Gospel of Matthew. We hear these words. Jesus said, at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. That's why a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. The two of them will become one. They are no longer two, but one. So, no one must separate what God has joined together. This is the Gospel of our Lord. Now we come to the heart of the service. Christian, will you have Tiffany to be your wife, to live with her in holy marriage according to the Word of God? Will you commit to grow together with her in faith and life? And will you love her, comfort her, honor and respect her, and stay with her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be her husband as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
And Tiffany, will you have Christian to be your husband, to live with him in holy marriage according to the Word of God? Will you commit to grow together with him in faith and life? And will you love him, comfort him, honor and respect him, and stay with him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be his wife as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Okay, dear friends, please turn and face each other. And repeat after me. I, Christian Croucher.
I, Christian Croucher.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
Take you, Tiffany.
Take you, Tiffany.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
Poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love,
to love,
to cherish,
to cherish,
and to grow together,
and to grow together,
until death parts us.
Until death parts us.
Hi, Tiffany Hollow.
Hi, Tiffany Hollow.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
Take you, Christian.
Take you, Christian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better,
for worse,
for worse,
for richer,
for richer,
for poorer, in sickness and in health,
to love,
to cherish,
to cherish,
and to grow together,
to grow together,
until death parts us.
Until death parts us.
O Lord, bless these rings to be symbols of the vows by which Chris and Tiff have bound themselves to each other. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Chris, if you take Tiffany's ring and repeat after me. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As my symbol.
As my symbol.
Of love and faithfulness.
Of love and faithfulness.
Receive this ring as my symbol of love and faithfulness. Well, Christian and Tiffany, now that you have consented together in holy marriage, have given yourselves to each other by your solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, your family and friends, I pronounce you to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. God has joined you together. Let no one separate you. Amen. Together now we pray the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now, dear friends, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. And Chris, you may now kiss your bride. Privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Christian Croucher.
Thank you. one little sip with me.
No, I'm going to drive it.
One little sip won't put you over the legal limit.
Yeah, it's going to burn off.
Did you get rounded up yet? Woo!
The flowers are dying. Okay, we're ready.
Awesome.
So how's this going? I'm in front of you.
You're the leader of the pack.
Yeah, you are.
Because you're the best.
Man. Yeah, show off some guys.
You're going to be next to last.
You
guys are going to be the first ones in.
Oh, okay.
All
right.
Maggie, you left
in
the
first round.
I cannot do that.
Oh, okay.
My name is Troy. I am your DJ for this evening. I've just been informed that the bridal party has arrived, so let's get them in here.
They've selected A Thousand Years, Part 2 by Christina Perry.
Thank you.
we have a lot of demands in our time in life, this day and age, and I'm just glad you all choose to spend it here this evening. I'd like to say a couple of words to Chris and Tiffany here. Chris, I just want to say it's been a real pleasure getting to know you the last 4.5 years or so. Watched you grow and develop. And, you know, I can remember the times we go out to eat, and the one time in particular stood in my mind, I was getting ready to get up and pay the bill, and you go, "No, sir, I'm taking care of this one." I'm like, "Wow, Tiffany, you found the keeper." I'm proud to say that. You know, love you as a son of mine. Glad you're part of the family. And Tiff, I don't know where these years went. They went fast, that's for sure. It just seems like yesterday I was watching you get on the school bus and going down the driveway, and your brother's chasing you all the way down, picking on you. He's made you tough, that's for sure. And I know you guys have been together for a little 4 years, and now you're married. Marriage is a continuous process, there's no doubt about that. And there's an acronym I'd like to have you guys kind of think about. It's RCA. It's respect, communication, appreciation. Yeah, just give you an example of appreciation. If Chris calls home and he says, "Honey, you need anything before I get home?" And you go, "Well, yeah, we could use some milk." And Chris comes home, gives you some milk. And just go up and give him a hug and say thank you. "I sure didn't want to get these 14 kids out of here to go to the store, that's for sure."
Causing chaos and doing a bunch of shenanigans with his van, like burnouts and blasting Rob Zombie and El Camino, just flying through fields and having a hell of a lot of fun.
And then we started tearing stuff apart and fixing it, like his car and his subwoofer bed. Coolest invention somebody ever told me. What, you don't like this type of speech? Well, you told me to prepare one. Where was I? Lost my spot thanks to you. Through our school career, we had a few goals in mind, and one that really stuck with Christian was his military career. And that's where we found out just how much his bride here, Tiffany, really supported him and cares and loves for him, and loves and cares for him. And to be able to support him and hardly ever see him and hardly ever talk to him, that's the hardest part. So I gotta give you props. And it shows us here just how much, Tiffany, you actually really mean to Christian and how much he means to you. So you did find yourself a keeper, clearly. There, Christian Crouch. Mrs. Crouch. So I'm honored to be your best man. And I could go on for days about you guys, and especially you. But we're all here today just to be here for your guys' most important time in your life. So that's why I'd like everybody to raise their glasses, and we're gonna have a toast for Mr. and Mrs. Crouch. I'm terrible at speeches. I'm gonna take this from me.
Thank you.
Okay, excellent. Here's how it works. Tiffany and Christian are going to take off their shoes, first of all. And each one of them... Wow, you guys are way ahead of me. So they each have their shoe and their partner's shoe. And I'm going to ask a series of questions. And if the shoe fits, then raise it, is the way that it works. So here we go. We'll do some easy ones first, just to kind of get things going. Who is the better driver? All right. Who's the faster driver? All right. Who has the most speeding tickets? Who has the most speeding tickets? Obviously, neither have ever gotten a speeding ticket. Is that correct? That's amazing. That is amazing. All right. Continuing on, who is the better kisser? Very nice. I think we're batting 1,000 so far, are we not? I think so. All right. Who is the biggest flirt? Wow. All right. Who made the first move? Think back. Who made the first move? No peeking. All right, that is awesome. Hold them up high. With conviction. All right. Who is the messier? Who is the messier? All right. Who spends the most time in front of the mirror? Agreed. All right. Who is the most likely to eat dessert for breakfast? Who will be doing most of the yard work? All right, who goes to bed earlier?
What?
Who goes to bed earlier? Very good. These two obviously know each other very well. So we're going to move on to some a little bit more difficult questions. Who is the best cook? Excellent. Who was the first to say, I love you? All right, which one has the craziest family? Who is the most likely to get lost? Who is the most likely to ask for directions? Who is the first one to make up after a fight? Who is the one who started the fight in the first place? Who says, I love you the most each day? And last, who do you love the most in the whole wide world? All right, let's hear it for Christian and Tiffany. Nice job.
Love you.
all seems so long. Burden runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt you?
I'm not going to be able to do it.